Hi, my name is Tim, and I can't stop thinking about things. A few days ago, I played Monochroma, and here is my thoughts. Let me just start out by saying that I'm gonna run game footage from my stream throughout this video, and it will not be necessary for you to watch it. Consider this more like a podcast, and feel free to draw pretty pictures, cook delicious meals, or whatever your heart desires while listening to this video. Also, this is going to be mostly spoiler-free, and I will warn you ahead of time when the relative small spoiler is upon us. Also, if you just want to know if I would recommend this game, I will tell you my judgment right up front. I don't like to work on the numeric scale, so I work on a scale of recommendations, and I give Monochroma a small recommendation. It's a stylish side-scroller platformer with light puzzle elements, easily compared to Inside or Limbo from Playdate. It's a relative short game that took me around 4 hours to finish and then around 25 minutes to collect all the collectibles in the game, thereby completing it. As of writing, the game is set to 20 euros or roughly $25, and that is too much in my opinion, so put it on your wishlist and wait for a sale. Games are best enjoyed unspoiled, so if you feel like trying Monochroma for yourself, go ahead and close down this video after the introduction and give it a go. Monochroma is lacking a lot of polish, but I still give it a small recommendation. And with that, my introduction is over. Time for my thoughts. In Monochroma, you play as the older brother, and you have to get you and your brother through the game's levels and story. The game has very simple mechanics. You run, you jump, you push and pull boxes and levers. Immediately, the game's first major problems present itself. The jumping mechanics is very sloppy and wobbly. You are often not entirely in control of where you are landing. Luckily, that is no more than a small time penalty, but it's frustrating and annoying, and I was making verbal complaints by the end of my time with Monochroma. But not only the controls need a lot of polish, but the animation as well. These are in no way critical for playing the game, but they keep the game from reaching a more than mediocre quality. Monochroma has some beautiful levels and it gets a lot out of its 3D assets. From time to time though, Monochroma's style is interfering negatively with the experience, as ladders can be hidden with the grey-on-grey color palette. Things you think are platforms able to support you are part of the background and you fall to your death. It's also possible to get lost in a game where you only move in two directions. Throughout the game you have to carry your brother on your back. Not only does he not help you in any way, but he also lets you jump less high. You can only put down your brother in certain locations that are brightly lit, and he doesn't help you with anything. Actually, most puzzles are solved by putting down brother in the cone of light, clear a path, return to brother, and continue. You can't walk too far away from your brother, so the puzzles never get truly complicated. All this combined is absolutely killing the relationship you are supposed to build up to your brother, and you start to seem like a little bit drag. Compare this to similar game duos like Banjo-Kazooie, The Last Guardian, or Elizabeth in Bioshock Infinite that actively helps you traverse the game's obstacles, and therefore you feel sympathetic towards them over time. Not in Monochroma, where you might actually end up hating your brother when he keeps insisting sitting down in inconvenient places. Even the companion cube from Portal is a more sympathetic character, and I'm required to remind you that the weighted companion cube cannot talk.
In the event that the weighted companion cube does speak, the Enrichment Center urges you to disregard its advice.
The story of Monochroma is minimalistic and told in the background, but nonetheless, it was so interesting that I couldn't stop playing. But this is where I will have to say goodbye to those of you that wants to skip the spoiler. It's a minor spoiler, and I still stand by my recommendation of Monochroma, even if it's a small one. Hope you enjoyed my video on Monochroma, and I hope to see you back for Oxenfree coming up next. I am Tim, and these were my thoughts on Monochroma. So, now I get to talk about